Welcome to Electro Online. We're now starting a new topic in electrical engineering called three-phase circuits. So the first question comes to mind, what is a three-phase circuit? Well, before we answer that question, let's take a look at the left side of the board here, where we have what we call a typical household circuitry that provides power to most homes. What we have here is we have a single-phase three-wire system. And what that allows you to do is provide power and current to devices that need 110 volts and to devices that need 220 volts, like electric stoves or electric dryers or washers. Well, no, washers don't need 220, but electric dryers, electric ranges and stoves do require 220 volts, where most other things such as light bulbs and toasters and things like that only need 110 volts. So we have two voltage supplies that are connected in series, but they're at the same phase. That's why we call it single phase. They are in phase so that the maximum minimum voltage is reached at the very same time. Notice that's a 110 volt system, but since they're in series, they're additive. So when we connect the wires like this, we can supply 220 volts. When we connect the wires like this, we can supply 110 volts, or we can supply 110 volts between these two wires as well, which is often done in home circuitry. So what is a three-phase circuit now? Well, we have what we call three-phase generators that produce voltages at three different phases, 120 degrees apart. For example, the three wires coming out of the generator, the first wire produces a voltage that reaches a maximum at 0 degrees, a voltage that reaches a maximum minus 120 degrees, and a voltage that reaches a maximum minus 240 degrees. You can see that those are all 120 degrees apart from one another. And of course, when you add 120 degrees up three times, you get 360, which is a full cycle of the generator. Now notice, in order to utilize a three-phase generator, we typically require what we call a three-phase load. They're specifically built to require three phases that are 120 degrees apart from one another. And notice that the neutral wire, the ground wire, is not necessarily used by the three-phase load. It can be in some cases, but it doesn't have to be. And especially if the three-phase generator and the three-phase loads are perfectly balanced, there should not be any current on the neutral wire, and therefore it would not be required. And sometimes we actually physically use the ground as the neutral wire. And we do that when we do transmission, and we'll get into that in a little bit more detail. But the idea is that we have a generator that produces three voltages, the same maximum value of the voltage or the same RMS value of the voltage, but the three voltages are supplied at a phase difference of 120 degrees. So when we draw a phase diagram, you can see that one voltage will be produced this way, one voltage will be produced this way, one voltage will be produced this way. And notice as the voltage rotates, which, because that's a phasor diagram, we'll have this one reaches the maximum over here, then there'll be 120 degree delay, so there's minus 120 degrees until the next voltage hits, and then there's a minus 120 degree delay until the next voltage hits, and then after 120 degrees, we come back to the first one. So if we take the first voltage here at zero, that would be this one right here. If we take the next wire, that would be this wire right here, if I get the top off, and then the next wire would be the one in black, that would be this one right here. Notice as the phasor rotates, we hit the maximum voltage three times in a single phase, 120 degrees apart. Drawing a diagram like this, you can see that we have our first voltage supply, 120 degrees later we have our next one, 120 degrees later we have our next one, and they're spaced nicely 120 degrees apart so that they hit the maximum at every 120 degrees in the cycle. We can write equations describing the voltage as a function of time. So we have a maximum voltage times the cosine of omega t for the first one, the maximum voltage times the cosine of omega t minus 120 degrees for the second one, and the maximum voltage times the cosine of omega t minus 240 degrees for the third one. There's a number of reasons why we want three-phase generators, and we'll get into the details of that later, but you can see at least from a typical overview, point of view, you can see what a three-phase generator is. We'll get into details of how exactly we produce it, what the advantages are, we'll have to calculate voltages and currents and so forth, but we'll get into all that later. At least what it does, it provides a more, what we call, even voltage supply and even power supply to make the load act a lot more, the way the load reacts to a three-phase generator is a lot cleaner. It provides a continual, almost a continual power. Instead of having that up and down cycle of a single phase, you have the three phases that come close together, 120 degrees apart, that allows a much more smoother functioning of things such as three-phase loads. And again, we'll get into the details later. Hopefully, that'll give you a nice overview right here, and then we'll get into the details of that in the videos to come.